Understanding My Better Half, A Guide to English Idioms. Hello, everyone. Welcome to our English language learning series. Today, we're diving into a charming and widely used phrase, my better half. This idiom is not just about words, but about culture and expression. So, let's explore its meaning, use, and origin together. My better half is a term of endearment used to refer to one's spouse or significant other. This phrase implies that the person being referred to is not only an integral part of one's life but also someone who complements or enhances the speaker's life in a positive way. It's a way of expressing love and respect, suggesting that this person is considered in some ways superior or more admirable. This idiom has a rich history. It originated in the 16th century and was initially used in a more literal sense. But over time, it evolved into a term of affection. Today, it's commonly used in both formal and informal settings. When someone uses this phrase, they're not just identifying their partner but are also expressing their affection and regard for them. Understanding this phrase also involves appreciating its cultural context. In English-speaking cultures, it's often used in a playful, affectionate manner. It reflects the idea of partnership and equality in relationships. This idiom also illustrates how language can be used to express complex ideas, like love and companionship, in a simple, endearing way. Let's see some examples. 1. I'd love to come to your party, but I need to check with my better half first. 2. My better half is an incredible cook. You should try their lasagna. 3. Can you hold on a moment? My better half is calling me. These sentences show how the phrase can be used in everyday conversation to refer to one's partner with respect and affection. And that's all about my better half. It's a beautiful way to refer to someone special in your life, filled with respect, love, and equality. We hope this video helped you understand this charming English idiom. Keep practicing, and see you in our next lesson.